Good evening and welcome to our concert tonight. Thank you for your patience as we worked out one of our first concerts in a while. And we're excited to be here tonight. We're glad to see a great crowd to honor our veterans and our community and our nation and our great nation and this great country, the United States of America. So thank you for being a part of that today. We're going to play Sometimes the transitions might take a little bit of time, we'll be as quick as possible. We're going to start with our national anthem, and it's a very unique and beautiful arrangement that we're going to play for a low brass ensemble using the trombones, euphoniums, and tubas. It was written for a college ensemble, and these young folks are playing it very well. And Mr. Weaver, also a young man, is going to be helping us with one of the parts of the day. It was written for 8 parts, so when we had somebody sick, we had to get someone to fill in and do that. So if you would, please rise for our national anthem. I'd like to take a moment to just introduce to you our brand new middle school band director, Mr. Ben Barber. why we make instruments that are tough. Tonka truck tough. All right. Is it good? All right. She's fine. Okay, she said she's fine. Whew. Did I catch my breath there? All right. Let me tell you, Mr. Bent Barber comes to us highly recommended. We had a lot of applicants for our middle school program. Close to 100 applicants if it came down to it. A lot of people want to live in this great area up here. Mr. Barber went to Fannin County High School for 1 year, his freshman year. And he was also went through grade 6 and through 8 with Mr. Chain as the middle school band director. And we're excited to support him. Let's just give him a big round of applause. You're welcome.
Tonight's program. The piece, according to James Swearingen, was written to honor the hardworking musicians performing on stage and the audience that we are so appreciative of attending and supporting us. We hope you enjoy Air Nobility.
Hello, my name is Millie Gibbs and I play the trumpet. The 7th grade band will close this portion of tonight's program with Night Fury by Carol Britton Chambers. This difficult and epic work is intended to portray a mythical time period full of adventure and excitement. You may very well envision dragons, castles, and other legendary creatures as you are taken on an energetic journey. We hope that you enjoy our final selection as we have enjoyed preparing this challenge but rewarding work. Without further ado, here is Carol Britton Chambers, Night Fury.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Joshua Cheatham, and I play in the percussion. Welcome to the 2021 Fannin County Band Fall Concert. The next group on stage to perform this evening is the Fannin County Middle School 8th Grade Band. We will be continuing tonight's program with a piece entitled Gothic by Tyler Arcane. This piece invokes sound and image of the awe-inspiring, towering and stained glass architecture of 12th to 16th century cathedrals and churches found across Europe, including the world's famous Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris, France. Tonight's performance of this work will feature flute soloist Tiara Tanner, clarinet soloist Gianna Torres and Wilkin Perry, and bass clarinet soloist Derek Green. We hope you enjoy Tyler Arcane's Gothic.
Thank you. good evening. Did you stay with us for just a moment? We're going to add, you know, just a few more friends for this next one as we honor our veterans. But I just want to take a moment to thank you all for coming out tonight. We really, really appreciate you guys supporting our program and especially our students. And we cannot thank you enough for all the support that you have given us for tonight. I do want to give a quick shout out. Some of you may have noticed that we had some high school students filling in. For both our 7th grade and our 8th grade band. We have some last minute call in 6th. Apparently there's a boat going around and kind of playing a couple of my students. But we are just so thankful. I'm just very, very thankful for high school students who have stepped in and helped fill in the spot. So thank you very much. I also wanted to say, as Dr. Barnstead was talking about, I am a very, very proud product of the Fayette County Middle School Band Program, and I just want to say it is an honor to be one of the next ones, the next band director here, and it's been a fantastic year so far, and I just want to let you all know I enjoyed it so much immensely. I am very, very happy to be here. I'm also very appreciative of the friendship and the mentorship of our high school band director, Dr. Scott Barnstead, and a man who's quickly become one of my dearest friends. Of course, now I'm talking about my predecessor, Mr. Mike Weaver. I'm so glad he is here tonight, supporting the band. Thank you so much, Mr. Weaver, for being here. All right, thank you very much. As I said, please bear with us for a few more minutes. We're still getting everything set up just a little bit more. Like I said, we're going to honor our veterans for just a moment. So we'll have another one of our 8th graders introduce the next tune. So if you please bear with us just for a few more moments, and we'll go ahead and get with our last tune of this portion of the concert. Thank you. Thank you.
clarinet. The 8th grade band, along with the members of the Fannin County High School Symphonic Band, will close a portion of tonight's concert with the Armed Forces March, arranged by Michael Sweeney. This march is a medley of the official songs of each branch of the United States Armed Forces. On behalf of all the students and staff of the Fannin County Band Program, we are and will be forever grateful to all the men and women who have served and protected our great nation. When your branch is called, we humbly ask that whether you are currently serving or have served in our nation's military, to please stand and be recognized so that we can thank you for your service and sacrifice. We also ask the members of the United States Coast Guard to please stand along with our Navy members. We hope you all enjoy our final selection of Armed Forces March.
Sincere thank you from a grateful nation. At this time, we're going to play a patriotic video produced by members of the FCHS Technology Student Association. We will turn off the lights, and we ask that while we do that, you please remain seated while the video is playing so that you can be safe, especially in the darker parts of the auditorium.
to me is a person that risks their life for others.
A veteran is someone who is dedicated to protecting those who live in our country.
A veteran to me is somebody who has given at least part of their life for the fate of their country.
A veteran is someone who gives up their freedoms so we don't have to.
A veteran to me is a he or she that went to war and sacrificed their life to make our country a better place.
We should honor our veterans because they have more courage than most people.
We honor our veterans because they put their life on the line so we don't have to.
We should honor our veterans because they risk their lives every day just so we can have our freedom.
We honor veterans because they made a choice to serve.
Because they went out and war, protected their country for people they didn't even know.
The people that fight for us, and we're not the ones fighting.
We should honor our veterans because of everything they do for our country. That and my grandpa's veterans, I really respect them for that.
They deserve every bit of honor that they can get.
We honor veterans because they fought for us and sacrificed their lives.
Endured hardships, and in some cases made the supreme sacrifice.
They are the ones who put their lives on the line for you.
We honor our veterans because of their service and their sacrifice.
Thank you, veterans.
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 Thank you very much, veterans.
Thank you, veterans.
It is with a great amount of respect that I say thank you, veterans.
Hunched over the heater on a cold and rainy night in New York in 1930, songwriters Hoagie Carmichael and Stuart Gorrell started musing about the beauty and pleasantness of a gentle summer night way down south. They turned their conversation into a song that has been recorded and performed time and time again and has become an audience favorite and our official state song. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoyed Georgia on My Mind. During his time in the U.S. Army. He set the work aside for several years, but pulled it back out for a 1938 Armistice Day celebration. Kate Smith sang the song in this radio broadcast and made the song her signature number for the rest of her career. God Bless America has been performed countless times through the years, but probably never so emotionally as when the members of Congress sang together on the steps of the U.S. Capitol building on the evening of September 11th, 2001. Thank you.
I'd like to just showcase some of my former students that, or it could have been Mr. Moses' students too, but I believe all of these were my students that are currently serving in the military right now. I thought about how can I recognize all the Fannin County Band alumni that are in the military. That's a lot, and I would leave somebody out. So I thought the best way is what we've done tonight is recognize our veterans that are here. There have been countless folks from our community that are serving and have served. But these folks that I'm gonna read out to you are students that have graduated since 2005, since I've been here, and all of these folks are currently serving right now. I'm gonna call their name out and hold our applause to the end. Michael Jones, U.S. Army. Jonathan Jones, U.S. Army. Drew Clayton, United States Air Force. Taylor Gibbs, United States Army. Allie Jones, United States Marine Corps. Alex Johnson, my son, United States Air Force. Jonas Garcia, United States Army. Tyler Treon, United States Army. Adam Boyce, United States Air Force. Whitney Cacchetti, United States Army. Emily McDaniel, United States Army. Seth Mathis, United States Army. Lori Meisner, United States Army. And these two gentlemen are in training. Thomas Barthoff is representing us in the United States Air Force Academy, and Dawson Workman is part of the UNG Corps of Cadets. Let's give them a round of applause. There is definitely a sweet, sweet spirit in this place, and I thought it would be appropriate to think about all the folks, all the sacrifices that folks in our community and around our nation are putting forth for our freedom. Freedom is not free, and it truly is an honor to be here tonight to talk about these folks and to bring them and rise them up and to just celebrate all that they've done for our country. Here is Sweet Sweet Spirit.
Thank you. veterans.
Thank you, veterans, for your service.
Thank you, veterans.
Thank you, veterans. Thank you, veterans.
Thank you, veterans. Still serving us today. In the years that the United States has existed, there have always been kind-hearted and patriotic people that protect this country. These soldiers keep us safe in many different ways. Some U.S. soldiers defend our land and sea. Others protect us from threats in the sky. But the one thing all these men and women share is bravery. The bravery of these veterans and active duty military members is something we'll forever be grateful for. So on behalf of the Fannin County students and staff, thank you, veterans.
Thank you.
recognize two soloists, actually, because I didn't recognize In Georgia On My Mind. In Georgia On My Mind, when we started off, Will Watkins on the trombone, give him a round of applause. And just a moment ago on the trumpet solo, Angel Garcia. It is our mission of the Fannin County High School Band to give young ladies and gentlemen the opportunity to learn to lead and to learn a skill and to learn how to work together. And one of the most important things that we do as we go through this process, to me, is central to it, is our Veterans Day program that we put together. It is crucial to me that we are always a part of the Veterans Day ceremonies that are at the middle school, the parade, and of course, our Veterans Day concert that we're doing now. And then this Thursday, here at the high school, we have a fantastic program set up. The students are involved, the entire school is involved. If you want to, be proud of a bunch of students, you need to come to that and watch and see. Especially if you're a veteran, you definitely will be recognized. It is a sight to see 800 students in this room, silent, listening, being respectful. And it just goes to show that we really value this, and we want to continue to make sure that these students value the sacrifice that people are making for our country by serving in the armed forces. So thank you for being here, and thank you for supporting us. We want to continue that mission, ladies and gentlemen. One of the things that we require to continue our mission of performing at football games, being part of Veterans Day programs, putting on Christmas concerts, supporting different things throughout the community, is we need a strong band booster club, and we do. We have a very strong band booster club. Our president, Ms. Jenna Brown, is here, I believe, in the back. Let's give her a round of applause. There are many band boosters that help and do a lot of tremendous things, but like many organizations in this world, we always seem to have a small group of folks that do a lot of the work. I see the same thing at church, I see the same thing at school. It's just human nature. But we need you. If you're not coming to our band booster meetings, you can be a band booster. We would love to have you. The purpose of the band booster club is to make opportunities for our kids. We're going to Washington, D.C. We need people to help fundraise. We need people to be supportive. We need people to make sure that our students have what they need. Students are not denied anything for lack of funding. We make sure that we find the funding. We just ask that the students learn the lesson of meeting us halfway. We don't give handouts. We ask for people to be responsible, but sometimes people can't make the full price, and we all know that. And sometimes it's hard to financially have these opportunities. But that's what the Band Booster Club is all about, and that's what this community is about. I would like to see a longer list of folks in our program of people that are supporting the band. You don't necessarily need to be 9-12 or a grade 9-12 student of the band, but I urge you to be a member, to take part, come to our next Band Booster meeting. And see what goes on behind the scenes, our concession stand, supporting our football team. I am a strong advocate for our athletics. Our job on Friday night is support our football team, our Rebels. There's not a finer man for a coach as Chad Cheatham. And I go to the end of the earth for that man. And that's what we do. We support our football team, we support our students, and he supports us. I want you to be a part of that if you're not. So I invite you to be a part of it. Our next selection is one of our favorites. I know it's one of our patriotic music favorites. It's Lee Greenwood's God Bless the USA.
Thank you. Jackson. I served in the United States Army from 1969 through 1971. Paul Mathis, Army National Guard, 6 years.
Joe Adams, U.S. Marine Corps, Corporal, 2 years.
Bill Prather, United States Army, 2 years.
My name is James Black. I served in the Korean conflict from 1953 to 1955.
Yep. I'm Thomas Douglas Callahan, Sergeant, U.S. 5343-1520. I served in Germany from 1966 through 1968.
I'm Thomas Mills, Specialist, Fort Tyson, 4 Deuce Motorman with the 82nd Airborne.
My name is Jack Warner. I served in the United States Army 1964 through 66.
Doug Duvall, I was on board USS Derrick for 4 years.
Bill Jones, U.S. Army, 1962-64.
I'm Bill Stodgel. I was in the Air Force for 4 years, from 1970 to 1974, and I was a jet engine specialist during the Vietnam era.
Technician, 5th grade, World War II, U.S. Air Force.
Gerald McMillan, Chief Petty Officer, United States Coast Guard, served 20 years, retired in 1986. I'm also the commander of the AMVET here in Blue Ridge.
Chris McKee, Air Force, 65 to 87.
My name is Jim Callender. I've served in the United States Army as Lieutenant Colonel from 1980 to 2018.
Paul Hunter, I served in the United States Army until Vietnam in 1970 through 1976.
Roger Courtney, retired Sergeant Major, served in the Marine Corps from 68 to 74, and the Army from 74 to 2009.
Sonny Payne, went in 1969 to 71, Army.
Richard Crosley, and I served from 1966 through 1970, Vietnam, 1969 and 70, and Air Force, and 4 years.
All right, Steve Strickland, Army, 1969 to 71, Corporal Hart Stripe, Corporal.
James Postel, served in the Army, the Vietnam War over a year, and Military, 66, for the latter part of 60, almost 68.
Danny Brown, 1972, and I was in the Army.
Hi, I'm Rock McIntyre. I was in the Army, served 3 years, 1964, 1967, 1 year in Vietnam.
I served U.S. Navy, 1964 through 69.
Steve Cheatham, Army, 68-69, Vietnam.
Hi, I'm Deputy Summers, Tracy A. Summers. I served in the Air Force from 1979 to 2000.
Jim Rumbelow, I served in the United States Marine Corps from 1968 to 1976.
United States Navy, 1977 to 1989.
Dale Green, United States Marine, active duty 1967 to 1973, and reserves from 1973 to 1988.
Mike Hughes, United States Marine Corps, 1976 to 1997.
Served 1965 through 69, U.S. Air Force Sergeant.
Served 86 to 92, Ranger Sergeant.
Greg Defoe, I served from 1968 to 1973, United States Navy.
Blake Stiles, United States Army, 8 years.
My name is Jerry Williams. I served the United States Army 1969 to 1971, 69 and 70 in Vietnam.
My name is Justin Foster. I was in the United States Army for 12 years.
My name is Roy Bradford. I served in the United States Air Force from 1968 to 1972. That's 4 years service. Went to Vietnam. Went different places to Vietnam. I wouldn't recommend it.
Hey, Graham, Navy. Peacetime.
Larry Payne, Army, Spec 4, 66 to 68.
And Robert Gabriel, Navy, 19, machinist mate, Navy, 1943, 44, and 45.
Hello.
I am STS-1 SS Mills. I served U.S. Navy on board submarines from 1980 to 1992 during the Cold War, fighting communism and socialism. I had a lot of great friends on board the sub. We had some good times, mostly good times on there. And I was proud to serve my country.
David Henson, I was a specialist in the United States Army, 1987 to 1991, Pershing Missile crew member, Operation Desert Storm. Thank you.
My name is Shane Culpepper. I served in the Georgia Army National Guard from 1991 to 1997. I was a specialist for, and the main job that I did was I was an 11th Mike, which I was on a rapid fighting vehicle and a mechanized infantry.
Let's have a big round of applause for all veterans. We're going to finish out the concert tonight with a rendition of When Johnny Comes Marching Home. And it's a lot of fun. We passed it out a couple weeks ago, and it's a concert band arrangement. We've kind of been doing marching band stuff for you tonight, so this is a concert band arrangement. I hope you enjoy American Salute by Morton Gould.
Thank you.
Let's also meet Mr. Ben Barber of the Little School Band, as well as also in the Hall of Honor tonight. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming out tonight. We're still playing some football games, and we have some Christmas parades coming up, and our Christmas concert, I believe, is December the 16th. Hope to see you there. Thank you very much, and have a great night.